Hi, my name's Wayne Pekarsky and I work as a developer advocate at Google. Today, I'm going to talk about Android Wear and how you can take advantage of stacking notifications. Existing notifications, such as inbox style or those that use similar summary information, can be easily modified with just a few small changes to your code. This allows you to show additional information on a wearable device that's easily glanceable. These notifications will appear as a stack on the wearable, allowing the user to view and take actions on each one individually, all without having to pull your phone out of your pocket. Before we get started, make sure you've viewed the previous videos introducing development of Android Wear. There's more information and access to the developer preview available from our website here. So now, I'm going to work through an example of a simple messaging system for your pets. So these are my two awesome dogs, Mila and Dylan here, and they're going to be starring in this video. So let's say the dogs are wearing smart collars during the day, which can send notifications to you. On the phone, the notifications are shown together with a total number shown in the phone's notification area. When you click on the notification, this brings up the application to show all the details. On a wearable, it would be really cool if we could look at each one separately and perhaps take some specific action or ignore it until later. Then there's no need to pull the phone out of our pocket. So in this demo, you can see both a phone and a wearable emulator running together. On the phone, a notification is shown. And on the wearable, you can see there's a stack notification made up from multiple events. You can touch the notification and it will expand into separate messages. You can touch the specific notification and then swipe it to the side to see possible actions. And when you use an action, that notification will be dismissed if it's been specified to do that in your code. You can then take a similar action on any remaining notifications. And remember, this can all be done while your phone remains in your pocket by interacting with your wearable device. So let's work through the code that was used to create this example. Firstly, this is the code that you would already be using to create a notification appearing on your phone. One of the nice things about the Android Wear APIs is that it leverages much of your existing code. Now, we create a notification that uses a group key string. This is a global identifier that Android uses to know which notifications should be grouped together on the wearable. It can be any string that you want. This is the first notification that will appear on the wearable. You start off by creating the intent and the pending intent with whatever result you want. This is exactly the same as you would do for your existing notifications. You then create the notification with the specific details of the message in exactly the same way that you would have done it with your existing code. Note that this notification is never meant to appear on the phone, only on the wearable. And we use the call to set action to indicate an intent for when an action icon is touched on the wearable display. You then need to build the notification for the wearable with a call to set group, which puts it in the group specified previously with the string constant. And this is the second notification that appears on the wearable. The code's basically the same, except the message text and the action are different. And finally, we issue the notifications to Android so they appear on the phone and the wearable. We issue all three of them separately with unique ID numbers. This part of the code issues the group notification appearing on the phone and would probably already be in your existing code. Make sure you use a notification manager compat instead of the notification manager from the framework when you're dealing with wearable devices. And now we can issue the notifications for the wearable device. And that's it, we're done with this example. So you can see how easy it is to add stack notifications to your applications. Most of your code and APIs used remains the same, and you can just add a little bit more to specify the grouping. You can use stacks in any application that might generate many notifications that you'd want to group together. So some examples could be an email client, an instant messaging application, and so forth. There are so many other cool possibilities of what you can do here. This is really just the start of what I've shown here. Android Wear is really exciting new technology that's going to allow all kinds of really neat applications from developers just like you. So you can find out more about Android Wear and the developer preview by visiting our website. You should also join our Google Plus community and share your ideas with everyone there. I'm Wayne Pekarsky, and I'm really looking forward to seeing what kinds of awesome ideas you all come up with. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.